south, my friends. Greetings, greetings, stargazers. I am Trace Dominguez. Astronomers visualize the stars in the sky as being glued to the inside of a fictional sphere that surrounds the Earth, known as the celestial sphere. Isn't that cool? When we look up at the sky, the horizon blocks our view of the whole celestial sphere, but of course the Earth rotates. This means that some stars appear to rise and set at the line of the horizon. At any given location on the Earth, there are stars on the celestial sphere that will never move above the horizon, which is why the sky looks different from different places on the planet. For example, here is what the winter sky looks like in North America from my hometown in Michigan. We can see familiar constellations like Ursa Major and Ursa Minor and Orion and the North Star Polaris aligned with the North Pole. But let's say we want to go on a trip south. As we move, the horizon shifts, revealing more stars and hiding others. As we pass the equator, Polaris will never rise or set. No more North Star. As we continue south, the celestial sphere changes even more. And at 20 or 30 degrees south latitude, we begin to see two large fuzzy objects popping up above the horizon. These two fuzzy objects are other galaxies in orbit around our own Milky Way. They are known as the large and small Magellanic Clouds. They're only visible from southern latitudes on Earth and were discovered by Ferdinand Magellan during his circumnavigation of the world. There are a number of other notable constellations and asterisms that are only visible from the southern hemisphere. For example, there is no bright star at the pole. Instead, there is Sigma Octantis. It's about 25 times fainter and not as easy to find in the sky as Polaris, but it is there. Although it's much easier to look for the constellation of Crux, also known as the Southern Cross. You can see it from Hawaii, Florida, or Texas in the United States if you know where to look. Hint, look south. Right next to Crux is the well-known Coal Sack Nebula, which is an area of very dense interstellar dust, obscuring our view of stars behind it. The southern sky has more than its share of celestial attractions, but remember, the seasons are reversed, so Bootes and Orion are not only upside down, but the former appears in the winter and the latter appears in the summer. The thing that blew my mind is to us, the moon is upside down in the southern sky. The familiar face in the moon becomes the mouse in the moon. If you get a chance, looking at the sky in another part of the world is a whole new adventure. So, as always, even when traveling, keep looking up.